much for being part of this New Indian Express session, and it's a pleasure to see you. Boman, you're also playing Farokh Engineer in 83. I'm very excited about that, and I think so are you, because he's a childhood hero of yours, right?
Absolutely, Kaveree. You know, it's so strange. I like to tell all the kids out there, you know, all those who love their Virats and their Dhonis and their Sachins. And for us, Farokh Engineer, when he played versus the West Indies in Chennai, and he almost scored a century before lunch. And, you know, he's this Greek god, you know, with the Greek god looks and you know, with a Greek god athlete straight from Athens in Olympia, bashing the West Indies. And we've seen all that. And I met him when I went to England for a holiday during the World Cup. And it was such a strange thing that while we were loading the van with my entire family and grandkids and wives and, Kunal is the wives, because Kunal is always, you know. And then the manager comes and tells me, you know, Farokh Engineer is in the lobby at the Taj in London.
Right.
I go up to him and say, hi, Kemcho, hey, come on, oh, so nice. Where are you going? I said, I'm going back to home. He said, don't go. I said, don't go. Everybody's in the car. He's saying, I went to the airport. He said, no, don't go. So I said, no, drop them to the airport and come back. I said, no, what are you talking about? He said, stay back. In a few days is the India-Pakistan match in Manchester.
Right.
Come and watch it with me. You can see it from the big famous balcony.
Wow.
I said, wow, but you know, I got to go. So he says, okay, we hugged each other. And I went, I sat in the car, and my wife, being the beautiful Zenobia that she is, I told her this happened. She says, you know what?
Do it.
Come home, come back in 3 days.
Right.
You can do that. You can do that for yourself. Come back, spend time with him. He's your boyhood hero. He's offered you to stay in his house. I'm not a good house guest. I feel very awkward. But I've never stayed in anybody's house. I stayed in his house. And we had the best time. I hung out with him. He took me for the match. I could do some research for my show. But I want to tell all those kids who love their Dhoni and their Sachin, you know, boyhood dreams, you know, come true. If you really want them really that hard. And it was like a boyhood dream. I can't tell you.
Wonderful. It sounds like a film script already.
Isn't it?
And you're doing a lot of that now, Boman, aren't you? You're a co-host of this script workshop, which you do every single day, which is called Spiral Bound. Talk a little about that.
I'm so excited that you asked me this. This is the most progressive thing that I've done in a long in years.
You've done many things, Boman.
Sorry?
And you've done a lot of progressive things.
You know, it's so important. I'm not co-hosting. I can't bring Alex down every day on the Zoom call. But Alex started it all. 7 or 8 years ago, when I set out to write my own script, I wrote a script. And I did a lot of reading and I did a lot of research and all that. And I wrote a script. And then I met Alex outside New York University once. He was then, he was a playwright. And I asked him, had he done any movies? And he says, yeah, I've done one movie, you know, it's an art house film, it'll come, it'll go, you know, it's one of those experiments. And I said, doesn't matter. And I shared my story with him. And he said, it's such a beautiful story. And if you need anything, send me pages and I'll just read them and give you notes. I said, my God, this lovely young, he's not that young, but this young man who, younger than me. This is a guy who would be happy to help me with my script. So he gave me some pointers and I said, you know what? I got myself a guru. Time flew by and 2.5-3 years later into that relationship, that's my granddaughter. Danish, keep it down, Danish. Yeah.
How old is she?
She's 1.5.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Yeah.
You don't look very grandfatherly. So
I can't
help
it. It's not my fault. It's not my fault. I can't help it. There's nothing I can do about that. So anyway, going back to this. So 3 years later, within the friendship and me trying to rewrite my script with his. He went and won an Oscar, you know. So I said, which was that film? Which is the film? So that same old film that you said will come and go, the art house film? He's saying, yeah. You see, I never thought that that film would become as big as it is. It's become a cult film now, Birdman.
Of course, Alexander, pronounce his second name, please.
Dinalaris. Just say Alex. He won't be
Alex Dinalaris, who wrote Birdman, which was an astounding film, wasn't it, Boman? It
had astounding.
Michael Keaton, who was just, it was a comeback film for him.
It was a huge comeback, a very brave thing to do.
Yeah.
You know, but you know what happens is that, you know, fame does funny things to people. And I thought he'd disappear out of my life. That friendship was over when I thought he'd win an Oscar. Won the Oscar. Yeah. Strangely, the friendship became stronger for some reason. I don't know how that happened. And then when I launched my company, Irani Movie Tone, I said, instead of throwing a big bash and a big red carpet affair and have a party and, you know, yeah, you know, we'll have a DJ and music. I said, let's inaugurate my company with a workshop for writers. And I thought that would be make so much sense because I think today what we lack is the science of writing. We may have great stories, we may have great story ideas, but they don't get translated into great screenplays. And that's a problem that I had. So I flew Alex down and I invited every student that is in the area, Pune included, FTII to Whistling, to everybody, plus all the script writers and young directors who wanted to be part of it. And we had this big party, which actually was just a workshop of 5-6 hours. And that continues today. But he's come to our, I conduct all the teaching workshops myself.
Online.
And we've done about 45 sessions. It's like a semester. Literally 2 hours almost every day. And then every evening I sit and talk to a couple of students, or I don't like to call them students, they're all practicing writers, two of the people who come there, with their film, maybe a script, a scene they may have written. And I spend about 40 every day, a little time in the evening just to chat with them. I think it's very gratifying. I think it's important. It's time to give a little back, Kaveree. I've had a wonderful run. I'm still having a wonderful run in the film industry. It's given me a lot, everything that I have, actually, including this phone and this laptop that we are chatting over. I think it's time to give back a little. I don't think that's a bad thing at all. I'm very proud, very proud.
What is the script workshop taught you? Because we often lament the lack of good writers in the Mumbai film industry, and we say, oh, you know, they're not given adequate respect. But a lot of that is changing, isn't it?
And it has to see. I think let's not put the cart before the horse. I think it's also that the script writers, we should pull up our socks. Also, the script writers are not paid well, not respected enough, and don't get protected enough. And I think it's very, very important that we have a system where we follow a certain paradigm, whatever the paradigm may be, and try and come up with the goods of solid screenplay writing. I said this before, I'm saying it again. Great ideas, great narrations. Great narrations for 15, 20 minutes. You tell me a story. I said, I can't believe this story needs to be made. But then to convert it into a 120-page screenplay is the problem. And that requires a little bit of craft and science. That's what I'm teaching. I've been going 7 years to New York, 3 times a year. I attend workshops there myself. I'm just sharing whatever I've learned over the last 7 years with Alex and my other teachers and all the books that I may have read. And my experience as an actor in the film industry too.
Please like our social media handles and subscribe to our channel by clicking on the bell icon.